Friends, in this video, we are going to study one of the important poem from your paper number 7, right? That is women's literature. And from this paper, we have from unit number 2nd, right? Unit number 2nd is devoted for the discussion and study of poetry, right? Here we have been prescribed with 2 poems. Out of those 2 poems, we are dealing with 1, right? In this present class, right? So the title of the poem is Song of Death. Song of Death. It is written by, right? It is composed by Gabriel Minstrel. Gabriel Minstrel is a popular 20th century poetess, right? She is a American Spanish poet, right? She is American Spanish poet who got Nobel Prize for literature in the year 1945, right? You will be asked questions about her career and her achievements. So you should note that her nationality is Spanish American. She is a Spanish American writer, poetess, and she got a Nobel. She received a Nobel for his poetic contribution to the world of literature in the year 1945, right? Apart from that, you should note that she is called the poet of motherhood, right? She is well known as poet of motherhood, right? These are 3 important things that you should note, right, as a bio sketch of this writer, right? This present poem, right, as its title suggests, has something to do with death, right? The invisible force, and it talks about the it is a fine expression of feminine, right? It is a fine expression of motherly love and motherly affection, right? The poem reminds us of many poems like Chinua Achebe's poem, right? Refugee mother and her child, or Indian poet Nassim Ezekiel, right? You know, you might be knowing this writer, Nassim Ezekiel. Nassim Ezekiel is an Indian writer, right? Bombay-born poet who also wrote a poem called Scorpion of Night. In that poem, he presents a mother from rural area who is happy just because the scorpion has beaten this lady, and it has spared her son, her children, right? So he expresses her thanks to the God that, oh God, thanks, right? You saved my children, right? This shows her sense of sacrifice and motherly love, right? So it is an excellent epitome. This present poem is an excellent epitome or excellent example, excellent specimen of motherly love, right? So what we call in Marathi, Vatsalta, right? Matrutva, right? These are the things which are communicated, expressed in the poem, right? The poem is full of imagery. Right, the writer Gabriel Minstrel uses different kind of figures of speech like simile, right, metaphors, right, in the poem. Words like milk, right, they are used for children, right, they are used metaphorically for referring right, newborn babies, right. Apart from that, you have many examples of figures of speech like simile. If you have gone through, right, if you read the poem, you'll find that in the last stanza, right, the poem is quite it has a moderate length, right? It has a 4, it has a 6 quatrains, right? Quatrain are stanzas of 4 lines. So this poem has 6 stanzas of 4 lines, right? So we have a 24 line poem, right, that expresses the motherly love, right, the theme of motherly love, right? While understanding poetry, you should note that you should be able to understand who is the speaker in the poem, what the poem is about, and who is speaking in the poem, right? The person, the voice speaking in the poem is called speaker. So in this present poem, we have a speaker, right, who is a mother, loving mother, caring mother, and she is expressing, right, her fears, and she is expressing his communication, right? We have a dialogue, right? We have a dialogue We have a mother, right, who has just given birth to a new baby, and she is trying to protect her in every way, but there is a looming shadow of a death, right? Death is there, right? Right, impending death is there, and she wants to protect her son against this death, right? Which is prevailing, right? There, right? She is addressing, right? She is addressing to the death, right? This invisible force. That's why he uses different images. If you look at the very first stanza, you'll find that in the very first stanza, she describes death as the old woman census taker. Death the trickster, right? To whom she is addressing in the poem? The mother, right? The mother is addressing to the death, right? Calling death as old women, right? She calls death old women, census taker, and death the trickster. These three words are used in the first stanza for referring death by the speaker, right? The first thing is, for the speaker in the poem, who is mother of a newborn baby, and she wants to protect her son, her baby, against the attack, against this, right, against this attack of a death, and that's why she describes, she calls death as, right, old women, right, old women. Second word used is a census taker, right? You know, census is the official counting of population, right? What you call in Marathi, Janaganna, right? So he describes death as a census taker and the trickster, death the trickster, right? It is the death which tricks, right? Which cheats we people, right? That's why she calls it a trickster, right? Trickster is nothing but a cheater. So she describes death as a cheater in the very first stanza. When you are going along, when you, right, she is talking with the death, right? She is asking, who is you in the poem? You will be asked a question. Who is you, right? Who is you? Referred in the first stanza. Referred in the first stanza. Your answer is death, right? You are going along. Who is going along? Death is going along, right? Death is fastly moving. Death is doing her activity continuously, right? She is marching towards, right, the newborn baby, right? Right. That's why she is terrified. The mother in the poem, she is horrified, terrified, right, with the fear that her newborn baby, right, right, should not be taken by the death, right? Right. You can understand the situation. Now we are facing the challenge of this COVID-19. That's why we see that death is impeding, right? We have a looming shadow of death, right? Death is, right, following us. Right? That's why there is a typical situation where there is a mother who has given a birth to a child, baby, and she wants, right, she visualizes death around the around her, and that's why she wants, right, to protect the baby from every from every attack, from every peril. Okay, so don't you meet my baby. This is the first stanza, the last line, right? Don't you meet my baby, right? Right, you are right, you are around my baby. This is the communication of the speaker in the poem. In the second stanza, she writes, I have already posted some 16-17 MCQs. If you go through the MCQs, you'll find what are the answers, right? I have deliberately kept right answer key with me, right? After reading this poem, you'll understand what is the right. You have to solve it, right? So note it in your notebook, right? It may lose, you'll lose that communication, right? If you delete that message, you'll lose. So you should write on your notebook, right? The second stanza reads like this: sniffing at newborns, right? To sniff is to smell, right? Sniffing at newborns, smelling for the milk, right? The word milk here represents newborn babies, right? Newborn baby and the milk, they are similar words in meaning in this context, right? She is addressing to the death, right, this invisible force, saying that, right, you are smelling for the milk, right? You are finding, right, a way to reach my baby, newborn. You are fond of, right? You are interested in, right? You are interested in, right, catching newborn baby, right? That's why you are smelling, right, the milk. You are approaching with the intention to, right, take my baby, right? Find salt, find cornmeal, don't find my milk, right? See, she is using different images from domestic life, right? Here, all the words, I told you that, right, in our earlier lectures, that poetry is oblique communication. Poet never speaks in a straightforward way, right? He uses in a specialized language. The language of a poetry is a language of images, right, where a writer, the speaker, uses different images. Here, the word milk means newborn baby. So, you can understand what will be the meaning of a cornmeal, right? Cornmeal or salt, right? Salt and cornmeal, these are other things, right? It means that she is asking the depth that you can prefer, right? Other people, like old people, sick people, right? So, you should not, right? You should not cast evil eye on my newborn baby, right? You can take another, you can take old people, right? This kind of attitude, this kind of feelings are expressed by a mother that reflects her profound sense of motherhood and that expresses her passionate, right, motherly feelings. Don't find my baby. Don't find my milk, right? Don't look for, don't come close to my baby, right? This is the communication. This is the, right, exhortation. She's exhorting, right? She is telling the depth by force, right? Right, with bold, right, she is boldly asking the death not to come close to my son. This kind of attitude we find in the second stanza. Again, in the third stanza, she is describing death with different words, right? Here in this third stanza, she describes death as anti-mother of the world, right? Death, according to the narrator, is against all the mothers in the world. Right? According to the narrator, according to the speaker in the poem, death is against all the women, all the mothers of the world. Right? So, death is anti-mother of the world. Right? Because death takes the newborn babies of a mother. That's why death is, right, the death is enemy of the mothers of the world. Right? Anti-mother of the world. People collector. Right, second adjective used by writer, the expression people collector, right? It is the death which collects people, right? That's why she calls people collector, anti-mother of the world, people collector, on the beaches and byways, don't meet that child, right? She says that, death claims lives on different places. Right, different places like beaches, you find people dying on beaches, at seashore, people dying on the byways, right, byways, right, that's why these are the places where death collects people, right, people collector at beaches and byways, don't meet that child, right, are you not searching for that child, right? We come to know, from the very word, we can construct the psychology of a mother, how she is terrified, how she is hysterical, how she is psychologically disturbed, right, when she is face to face with the death and she is so scared, right, she is scared that her newborn baby will be taken by the death. That's why in that emotional state, she is communicating the thing which that strikes to her mind, right? The name he was baptized, that flower he grows with, forget it. Rememberer, lose it, death, right? In the fourth stanza, she is requesting, she is imploring death that you should lose my child, right? Please don't come close to my son, right? You can take other things, you can take salt, right, you can take cornmeal. It means that you can prefer other people, like old people, sick people, right? But please, but don't come to my newborn baby, right? Milk, right? See how the words in the poem, they are connoting different meaning than our real life words, right? Here the words like milk, cornmeal, salt, these are the words which refer to human beings, right? If milk becomes a child, then salt can be, right, read as old people, sick people, right, unfortunate people, right, grown-up people, right, the people who have seen the world, right, let my small child, right, see the world, don't lose it, right, I don't want to lose it, right, so, right, she is narrating how she has the baby, right, and how she has baptized, you know, baptize is a festival, ceremony in Christianity, right, in Marathi we have Namkaran Sola, right, in the same way, in Christianity there is a special festival, there is special ceremony, right, name giving ceremony, which is called baptism, right, baptism, where, right, a newborn baby, right, from a Christian family, they are worshipped with water and they are given name, right, and then after that ceremony they become Christian, right. So she says that I have just baptized my son, my baby, right, I have named him after the flower, right, along with, right, that flower he grows with, right, I have named the son, the baby, I have named the baby after the name of a flower, right, we have a name like gulab, right, gulab is a name given to, right, we give different names, right, the names of flower to our children. In the same way she says that I have just a baby, right, and I have baptized her, I have given her name, right, I have assigned, right, I have given a name, I have named it on the, right, I have named it after a flower, right, I have given the name of a flower to my baby, right, and the baby is growing like a flower, right, and please forget it, right, remember her, lose it, death, right, don't come to my baby, right, forget, right, you can, right, you look anyway, you find other thing, right, you forget about my baby. This is the communication, this is the request, right, this is the imploration, right, this is the appeal, right, this is the earnest request made by a mother, speaker mother to the death. So we have two characters in the poem, right, one is visible, right, human character called mother, and the other is death, invisible character, right. A late wind and salt and sand drive you crazy, mix you up so you can't tell east from west, right. So she says that, right, late wind and salt and sand, right, drive you crazy, mix you up so you can't tell east from west, right. She is expecting that daring people, right, the people who have the courage to defeat death, right, the people who are dominant to death, right, deathless, the people who don't scare death, right, the people who never get terrified by death, who want to destroy death, who wants to, right, who never bother about death, right, these people are referred as sand, wind and salt, and she is expecting that these people, like the people who don't fear death, right, these people, right, desperate people, right, which is represented in the form of wind, salt and sand, drive you crazy, right, they should made you crazy, they should make you upset, they should make you bold, right, so that you will not be a powerful force claiming the lives of little babies, right, or mother from child like fish in the sea, and on the day at the hour find only me. See, the last line is most beautiful expression of motherly love, motherly affection. What she is saying in the last stanza? In the last stanza, she is saying, she is asking, right? She is telling to the death that, right? Okay, no matter. If you want a life, right? You can take my life, right? Right? Mother from child, right? She is using simile, right? The figure of speech called simile, right? See the use of words like here we have a comparison between mother and a fish, right? For the speaker, a mother away, right? A mother who is kept away from her child is like a fish in the sea who is kept out of water, right? So such is a plight, right? Such is a condition of mother. That's why she says that, right? Mothers are like that fish out of water, right? You can't understand their psychology, right? And even though you want a life, right? Even though you want to take the life, you can take my life, right? Right? And on the day, right? Right? If you have selected the day to taking life from my family, right? And on that day, at that hour, when you are claiming a life from my family, find only me, right? You can take me, you can kill me, you can take my life, but please forget, lose my child, right? Spare my child, don't touch my child, don't cast your evil eye on my child, my newborn baby. This is the humble request, exhortation, emotional outpouring of a mother, right? That we come to know from the poem. It is very simple, easy to understand poem, right? At the very first reading, you can understand. There are different words, right? Different images. You need to interpret it. You can have multiple interpretations. This is one sample interpretation I have provided so that you can understand the poem. Read the poem repeatedly and try to understand other deeper meanings of the poem.